Skip database is a requirement based on the revised Waste Framework Directive of 2018. Skip stands for Substances of Concern in articles as such or in complex objects. And so basically it is a database where industry has to provide information to. This database is established and maintained by the European Chemicals Agency. And the first deadline for submission of the data is 5th of January 2021. Skip notification is basically the submission of the required information by the duty holders to the Chemicals Agency using the Euclid software. And the notification requirement basically applies whenever a candidate list substance is present above 0.1% in a given product on a component level. And if that is the case, then the duty holder has to inform about the identity of the product that is supplied. Has to give information about the SVHC and its location and also the concentration range, and where necessary, additional safe use information for the product also needs to be submitted. It is important to know that the information required for skip notification goes beyond the existing REACH obligations under Article 33, which is a concern for many industries. Duty holders are by law any EU article suppliers, so this can be a producer of an article, an importer who's supplying onwards to professional customers, it can be distributors, so all kinds of actors in the EU supplying articles. Non-EU companies do not have a direct possibility to submit such notifications. So they have to provide the required information to their EU customers or find ways to become a notifier themselves. Especially the electronics industry is very much impacted. Also everybody producing vehicles, aircraft, cars and so on. But it also extends to sectors like healthcare, machinery, furniture, textiles, whatever you can imagine, but what can potentially include a substance of very high concern. Most of the companies who already know about it today, they are concerned about the lack of information. They don't have sufficient information available to fulfill the skip requirements. So they have to get them from the supply chain, this information if possible. And they are also concerned about the magnitude of notifications that may be required. So they don't know whether they will be able to submit that information in time to ECHA. And also, they are not sure whether ECHA can actually cope with the magnitude of notifications. So there's a lot of uncertainty today. And also, I think Skip is a big learning experience for everybody now, because companies have to learn how to deal with a very novel requirement on substances in products. Imminent actions are to clarify internal responsibilities first, have people to be in charge of Skip to determine whether a notification requirement or requirements exist for given products. And then if this is confirmed, then preparations for notification should start. You have to see what information you need and how you get this information. You need to know how to use the ECHA submission tools and organize this entire project for your company to be ready to submit notifications. Basically starting from October this year, when it will be possible to submit notifications, but the deadline will only be 5th of January in 2021. it is also important to realize that this Git notification is really an issue for the whole company. It does not only affect health and safety or regulatory departments, but also supply chain experts, IT, especially if you want to make a system-to-system transfer of notifications to ECHA. And also the executive management should be well aware what's happening and how it will probably affect their continued business. Thank you very much for following Reach Lar Talks, and you can of course follow us further on YouTube.